In this video, I want to talk about how you can configure Docker to work behind a proxy server. If you are configuring Docker deployments in a private cloud environment, or maybe you just need to pull images from a registry hosted in a corporate network, chances are the your sysadmin will probably tell you to connect using a proxy server. One thing that may be confusing with Docker and proxies is that the Docker daemon and Docker containers don't share the same proxy configuration. Well, let me save you some time and headaches and repeat it again. You will need to provide your proxy settings for the Docker daemon and also for each individual container. I'm now going to show you how to do both. For this tutorial to work, I have configured a few CentOS machines on AWS, so this node I'm using can connect to the internet only via the proxy that is now running on another node on port 3128. If your Docker daemon is not configured to use the proxy correctly, you will typically see timeout errors when using Docker login to log into a private registry, or when pulling images in general. To test the connection, let's try pull the Alpine image from Docker Hub. And we get a connection timeout. I'm now going to show you how to solve this problem, whether you're running Docker on Linux or Docker Desktop on a macOS or Windows. If you run Docker Desktop, the solution is very easy. Just open Docker Preferences from your OS interface, navigate to Resources, Proxies, switch to Manual Proxy Configuration, and provide the URLs for your HTTP and HTTPS proxy, and the list of hosts that don't need to proxy connection, usually localhost and 127.0.0.1. Click Apply and Restart, and just wait for Docker to come back up again. If you run Docker on Linux, the easiest way to change your proxy settings is using systemd. Your Docker daemon is most likely installed as a systemd service and can be customized by using the environment variables HTTP proxy, HTTPS proxy, and no proxy. Now, this is not going to be a video about systemd, so I won't bother you with the details, but if you are facing any issue with systemd configuration, ask a question in the comments and I will do my best to reply. For this test, I'm using CentOS environment, but you should be able to replicate the following steps in almost any Linux distribution. To customize a systemd service on CentOS, we can use the systemctl edit command. So sudo systemctl edit docker.service. You'll notice that systemctl opened a blank file with your default editor. We can use this file to provide additional configuration or override the existing docker.service unit file. Let's type the following. Service between square brackets to start the section definition, and set the proxy configuration as environment variables for this service. I'm going to include the configuration snippets in the video description, so check it out if you want to copy-paste it into your own environment. When we are done defining our variables, we save and close, and restart the Docker daemon with sudo systemctl restart docker.service. We can verify our proxy configuration has been applied with docker info and filter for the proxy keyword. We can see that our variables have been loaded by the Docker daemon, so if we now try to pull an image from Docker Hub, it should work. Great! But what happens if we try to run a container and access some online content? Let's run an Nginx container, and curl google.com. After a few minutes, we get a connection timeout. As I told you, this happens because running containers don't share the same proxy settings as the Docker daemon. To access the internet, we will need to set the HTTP and HTTPS proxy variables for the container. This can be done in a Docker file or at runtime with the env option, although I recommend that you avoid doing so in the Docker file, which makes the image less portable. Let's run the Nginx container again, but this time, configure HTTP and HTTPS proxy variables. Docker run. We set the environment variable for HTTP proxy. Same for the HTTPS proxy variable. Image will be Nginx. And the command curl google.com again. And this time, the container successfully connected to the internet. Setting proxy variables on containers is easy, but it gets boring very quickly since you'll have to do it for every new container. A better way to do this is configuring default values for the Docker client. So these settings will be applied for all new containers that the current user runs. To do so, we need to create or edit the .docker/config.json file in our user's home directory. In my case, I need to create it and add the following configuration. Same here, I will include the snippet in the video description for you to copy, but essentially, we are just providing default values for the same three variables we've set before. Save and close. And now all new containers started by this user will have the proxy settings applied by default. Let's test the result of this last configuration by echoing the HTTP proxy variable for a new container. And the variable has been set by the Docker client now. One final test to try connecting to google.com again. And it works as expected. I hope this clarifies how Docker works with proxies. Please let me know if you liked this video with a thumbs up or a thumbs down if you didn't like it to help me improve. I do my best to upload new content every week, so subscribe to the channel if you like to learn more about Docker and containers. Thank you very much for watching until the end, and see you in the next video.